بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على السيد المرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. I do not stand here as an uninterested outside observer. I was blessed by Allah Ta'ala to spend almost 7 years of my life in Syria, living amongst the people in Zahra Qadima and Muqayyam Yarmouk and Muhajirin in different neighborhoods, meeting the people. I know people who have lost family members in this struggle. I know people who have been forced into exile as a result of this struggle. And I'm sure I know people who are imprisoned as a result of this struggle. We should be clear about one thing, that this struggle should not be about land. It should not be about power. It should be about principles. And amongst the principles we uphold first and foremost is the sanctity of human life. Because Allah Ta'ala tells us in the Quran, من قتل نفسا بغير نفس أو فساد في الأرض فكأنما قتل الناس جميعا. Whoever kills a soul for no just cause is as if they've killed all of humanity. All of those 20 or 30,000 people, most of them who have been killed during the course of this struggle, they were innocent human beings, men, women, and children who did absolutely nothing to no one. And first and foremost, we stand for them. We stand for their sacrifice, for their blood, and for their honor. And it is in their name, it's in their name and their dignity that we want a free Syria, where every human being can express their opinion, where every human being can stand against tyranny, oppression, dictatorship. Rather, that dictator says, dominates and oppresses by using socialism or nationalism or communism or misusing Islam and the principles of Islam. If they are wrong in the eyes of Allah, then they're wrong in our eye, no matter who they are, what they say, how they try to disguise their oppression, their murder, their tyranny. We will stand against them. And the we stand for the sanctity of life. We stand for the dignity and the tolerance, the tolerant spirit of the Syrian people. And we say to the world that that spirit will prevail. We will not allow any outside power. Rather, that power is headquartered right here in Washington, D.C. Rather, that power emanates from a cave in Afghanistan or wherever. No outsider will come in and transform the tolerant nature of the Syrian people. We will not. We will stand against sectarian killing, sectarian violence, stand against murdering people because they might differ in us, in their opinion. That's what we stand for. And that is the Islam that has made Syria great. It is not the Islam that cuts the throat of someone because they might have a different view of Islam. It is the Islam that allowed the Syrian people the honor of leading the armies that took Islam from the foothills of the Pyrenees and the Spain and Portugal in the West under the leadership of Musa bin Nusayr, and took Islam to the wall of China in the East under the leadership of Qutayba bin Muslim. Those armies that emanated from Syria, they were able to win the hearts of people, and they were able to conquer the lands because they stood for principles rooted in the fundamental principles of the Quran and the Sunnah of our Prophet. And that spirit has made Syria one of the greatest lands of Islam. And if the future of Syria is to be built on an Islamic foundation, it will be built on that foundation of principle and respect and tolerance. We're here not because we are planning for the downfall of the dictatorial authoritarian Assad regime only. We're here to reflect on the principles that the future of free Syria will be built on, because inshallah, the Assad regime will fall. It will fall. The question then becomes, what will replace it? And as we contemplate and organize and bring our hearts and our spirits together to work for the fall of that regime, we have to be equally committed to working for what will replace that regime. And we have to understand that what will replace it will be built on uncompromising principles that will reflect respect the freedom, the dignity, and the life of every Syrian under the leadership of leaders that are committed to freedom and popular rule, leaders that are not only committed to Islam and to allowing the beauty of the Islam that defines the Syrian Muslim people, but also are committed to an Islam that allows the Christians to continue to exist and prosper in Syria. And Islam that is committed to protecting the life of a Nusayri neighbor who hasn't done anything to anyone, and saying you're free to continue to be my neighbor, to live in peace and tranquility because you are an innocent soul. And Islam protects innocent life. As for the guilty people, in conclusion, we don't stand here today, or we do stand here today, to tell the White House, and we pray it will become the right house by doing the right thing by the Syrian people. To tell the White House, to tell Damascus, to tell the United Nations, and to tell the Kremlin, and anyone else who would listen, but first and foremost, to tell ourselves that we don't stand here to contemplate replacing one form of tyranny with another form of tyranny. Tyranny in the name of Hurriya, Ishtirakiya, wa Qawmiya, with a tyranny that says La ilaha illallah. We're here to replace one form of tyranny with a form of freedom that's based on La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah, but extends life and liberty and honor and dignity to everyone who will come under the protective umbrella of La ilaha illallah, be they Christian, be they socialist, whatever they be, that this umbrella of La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah, will create a model country that will be an example for the world. And this is the only thing that the blood of those 30,000 martyrs is worthy of. Takbir. Takbir. Takbir.